How much does it cost to start an eBay dropshipping business? That's what we will talk about in this video, and I will show you all of the required things that you need to have to start an eBay dropshipping business, and I will show you how much each and every of these parts of the business will cost you when you start an eBay dropshipping business. Short intro and we are starting. Hello everybody! So, as you just saw, subscribe to this YouTube channel right now for more high quality dropshipping videos for beginners and advanced dropshippers. So, in this video I will show you exactly what are the parts of the business that you need to take in conclusion when you want to start an eBay dropshipping business. I will also show you exactly how much each and any of these parts of the business will cost you when you're just starting and opening your first dropshipping business. So let's start. The first thing for eBay dropshipping will be, of course, an eBay store. So let's see how much will it cost us. So I will go to Google and write here eBay insertion fee. First of all, what is the eBay insertion fee? In eBay, we have two different types of fees. The first one is eBay insertion fee, and this fee is the fee that we pay to eBay for any listing that we are adding to their marketplace. The second type of fees is eBay final value fee, and this fee will be paid to eBay only after the product was sold successfully. It means that basically we don't have any risk for final value fee because we will just add this percent to our price. So let's first focus on the eBay insertion fee and how much this fee will cost us when we start a dropshipping business. So I will scroll down here, I will go to eBay fees, and I will scroll here a bit down and I will see here the insertion fees section. As you can see here, every month you can get up to 50 zero insertion fee listings. Here they talk about eBay.com, but for eBay UK, eBay FR, for example, the limits are different and you need to check it for each and every different marketplace. But in general, 50 is the minimum, and for any type of eBay marketplace, you can list at least 50 products for free every month without any insertion fee and without any risks. For the other part, as I said, you don't have any problem because the final value fee will be just added to your price on eBay when you calculate the price of your products. About eBay store subscription. Store subscription is also something that we can do to get more listings without any insertion fee, and this will cost us a bit money. But it's not a problem at all, because when you just start a dropshipping business, 50 products is completely enough for you and you can just start for free without any insertion fees and without any fees to eBay until you get your first sale. Let's jump into the second thing that can cost us money and see how much this part of the business will cost us. And I'm talking here about PayPal. PayPal is an online bank which linked to eBay, and when you get a payment from eBay's buyer, it will go to your PayPal account, and then from there you can withdraw this money directly to your bank account or credit card. Now, let's see what are the PayPal fees. So if I go to PayPal and I go to merchant fees, I can see here the standard transaction fees. To open a PayPal account, it's completely free, so here the situation is pretty the same as we have on eBay. To open the account is free for both eBay and PayPal, and you pay to PayPal only after you get a money. So it means that only when you really make a profit and only when your products really sold, only then you will pay to PayPal. So in this case, also our budget that we need to start an eBay dropshipping business is still zero. You don't have any fees and you don't have anything that you need to pay in advance before you start basically and really get profits. The next part of our eBay business will be a dropshipping software to list our products. So basically I can go to any of the suppliers that I want to use for my dropshipping business. For example, AliExpress, Amazon, Wayfair, Walmart, or any other supplier. and they can copy all of the product details one by one manually. So basically I can go to Amazon, take any of the products here. Let's say that I want to take, for example, this product, doesn't really matter. And I can go and copy everything from here to eBay one by one. I can copy the title, the price, the description, and everything here. But we don't really want to do all of this stuff manually. We don't want to copy the title, the description, the images, the item specifics, and everything there one by one manually, because it will take us a lot of time. Remember, we can list on eBay up to 50 products for free, and you don't want to list these 50 products one by one manually. So for this, we use something which is called a dropshipping lister or products lister. The products lister, what it does is it just copies all of the details from our suppliers page, products page, directly to our eBay store. Let's see how it works. So I will copy the link from here and I will go to my dropshipping tool. In this case, it will be AutoDS, which is our own dropshipping tool. So let's see. I go to AutoDS, I go to the uploader. Then I will just choose a supplier here and put the link. Then I just click grab details, and within a few seconds it will grab all of the details of my product. Let's see that. I got a Vero message. Vero is something that shows us that I cannot list this product because of copyright violation. This is another reason why we really need the dropshipping lister, because it will provide us a safer way to upload products to our stores without any copyright violation. So in this case, I will just click, let me continue just for the example. And I can see here that it grabbed all of the details. It already created the right price for me according to my break even, which is the price that in this price I will not lose money for PayPal fees or eBay fees. In this case, the break even is wrong, but you need just to calculate there the eBay fees plus PayPal fees. So in this case, it will be 2.9 plus 10% for eBay final fees. So I will just put here 14 to stay on the safe zone. So this is how, with the click of a button, we can just copy any of the products to our store. How much this tool cost us? So basically, this tool will cost us at least $8 a month, which is a super small budget for any real business in the world. But for the first week, you can try the tool for just $1. So basically, our budget that we need is still really, really, really low. I would still call it zero budget business, because $1 to start a business and to try it, it's not really a money. Now, the next thing that we need to run our dropshipping business is a repricer or monitor. Every dropshipper calls it in one of the two different ways. Now, for monitoring, what does it do? The monitoring tool, it will follow the pricing and the stocks of your supplier and adapt it according to the changes in your supplier site in your store. What does it mean? Let's say that this product will go to out of stock. It will put automatically the product as out of stock in our store, so we will not sell a product that we cannot provide to our customers. Same about the price. If the price will be increased, we will increase the price automatically, or the tool will increase the price automatically in our store for us. And in this way, we still always stay in the safe zone and we cannot really lose money in this business. Now, how much the dropshipping monitor cost? Same price, it's $1, because the AutoDS is an all-in-one dropshipping tool. So when you pay the $1 for 1 week trial, you can still keep and use the monitoring tool also. As I said, after 1 week, it will cost you $8 a month. The next thing that we need to have in our dropshipping business is a tool that will help us to find dropshipping products. This is the last thing that you will need for your business, and then we will make some conclusions and see how much really you need to spend in your dropshipping business for your first days. So, for product finding, we also cover you in AutoDS, and you have a tool that's called the AutoDS Finder. The AutoDS Finder is a tool that scans a lot of dropshippers on eBay and gives you their best products, so with the click of a button you can just choose a supplier and list any of their of these top products to your store with the click of a button here. How much this tool costs? You can list here up to 400 products for free. When you register to AutoDS, you just get this tool for free, so you can really start growing your business in the best way. However, we already talked about this, that the budget here is almost zero or just $1. But there is one thing that you need to take in conclusion when you want to start your business. And this is something that's called the PayPal jail. This is how people call it. Now, the PayPal jail means that when you get the money for the first time, for the first 3 months from when you opened your PayPal account, you will need to wait until this money will be released to your balance. Usually it takes around 2 weeks. Now, how to speed up this process and how does this process works? Let's say that you sold a product for $50. After you sold the product, you will get the money to your PayPal balance, and this balance will go to a balance that called on hold on PayPal. After your supplier will ship the product to your customer, so it means that you need to place the order in your supplier site, and then they will ship the product, so you will get a tracking number. When you put the tracking number on PayPal, after a few days, when your buyer will receive the product, you will get the money back to your PayPal account, and it will be released from the on hold status. So here we need to take in conclusion, and we need to think about this, that we will need to spend some money for our first products that we ship to our customers. How much money is it? I would say between $100 and $200, which is the maximum amount of sales that I think that you will make in the beginning before the money will be released, and then it will just start running. You will just start selling, and from the previous products, money will be released to your PayPal account, so you will not have any problems. So it means that basically when you just start your business, you need between $100 and $200 to spend for your first purchases. Now, you need to remember that this money is not real, a real investment, because you will get it immediately. You already got it, this money, but it's just on hold on your PayPal account. So it means that within a few days it will be released. So the risk here is zero. So how much it really cost? As we discussed, using all of the tools, eBay Store, PayPal, AutoDS, AutoDS Finder, which is the tool which will help you to find dropshipping products, and the fees of eBay and PayPal, everything together will cost you just $1 for the dropshipping tool for the first week, and after that it will cost you any package that you choose, starting from $8 a month. I hope that you like this video. I really, really recommend you to check the links below this video in the description to our blog and other knowledge bases that will help you to increase your dropshipping knowledge and start your way and journey at the best way. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, like this video, and ask us in the comments everything that you would like to know about dropshipping and about how to use the dropshipping tool AutoDS. See you in the next videos. Bye bye.